Get ready to match the stars. Ronnie Graham. Brett Summers. Carl Snuffson Riley. From Ages and Up, Susan Richardson. Otter Johnson. And Connie Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rather.
Thank you, friends. Here we go. Shall we?
Yes.
Hi, Gene. That's a clean remark.
Let's start that.
Would you please welcome Linda Rock and Michael Vita? Pause, pause, pause. Okay. Let's just quickly review where you're from. Michael, I've forgotten where what town you're from. Oh, you grew up in Detroit. You left there when you were 8 years old, and you live here now, right?
That's right. And I'm a pilot for commercial airlines in Southern California.
What, you fly jets?
No, I don't. I fly multi-engine airplanes.
Multi-engine prop planes?
Yes.
Uh-oh.
Oh, a rinky-dink airline,
huh? No.
You go far distances?
Not really.
Yeah. They don't go too far, do they?
About 30 miles.
30 miles?
At a time.
Okay. Now you have to guess the name of his airline. It's a new show. We just started there.
A wing and a prayer.
Now, Linda, refresh our memories about you.
I'm a housewife with 3 daughters.
Right.
And my husband's a building contractor.
I knew I heard that somewhere before. Okay, we're in the middle of round one here, and it's Linda's question, right? You want A or B?
I think I'll take B.
Okay. Paul said, when I was born, my parents left me in a locker room.
Uh-oh.
Oh. For years, I thought I was a blank.
Uh-oh.
When I was born, my parents left me in a locker room. For years, I thought I was a blank.
Well, now, wait a minute. That's not fair for those of us who are... We've never been in a locker room.
Come on, you better one locker room.
Good, yeah.
Testing one.
Paul said, when I was born, my parents left me in a locker room. For years, I thought I was a blank.
Pair of sweat socks. I don't know.
Okay, that's her answer.
Why are they so cruel to the contestants? They just move them. Yeah. What is that?
They're trying to make her feel at home.
Colosseum.
That's right, exactly. If we are the lions and they are the Romans out there.
We are the Christians and they are the Romans.
Whatever it is. Well, I don't know about that either. What do you say?
What do I say? Sweatsuit.
A sweatsuit. All right, that's something you'd find in a locker room. Anything you find in a locker room. What do you find in a locker room?
Now, let's let the judges be the judge of whether or not this is a match. I said a pair of dirty socks.
Yeah. Oh, naturally, that's
okay.
Very good.
Very good.
Okay, Chuck, what do you
say? I said for years, Jeannie thought he was a jock.
A jock, yeah.
Then you know what happened?
What happened? What happened? He thought he was a jock for years.
Yeah,
then
when he grew up?
What?
He was a sissy.
They're still talking about it down at the locker.
Yeah, what?
Susan, my dear.
Sorry, Mom.
Sorry, Mom?
Wait a minute. Did your mom have one of them?
Yeah, does your mom wear a jock strap? What's wrong?
Yeah.
Mom, take it off. Take it off.
Take it all off.
All of them. Okay, let's put that right there in that spot. All right, Artie, here
not
it is.
Not a match. Not a match.
Sneaker.
I thought it was a sneaker.
I was born in a locker room for years. I thought I was a...
Susan, we don't say jockstrap. We say athletic supporter.
That's what
we say.
And you've never been inside a locker room, right?
Okay, it's 1-1 here. The score is tied. Michael went first last time, so Linda will ask you to first this time.
B, please.
B. Round 2.
Who's winning?
Bong. Jim said to the sales girl... They said, I'd like to buy a bra for my wife.
Ow.
I want a size 7.5. A sales girl said, how'd you get that measurement? She said, well, I measured her with my blank. All right, Linda. Jim said to the sales girl, I'd like to buy a bra for my wife, size 7.5. And the sales girl said, how'd you get that measurement? And Jim said, I measured her with my blank.
Hands.
Hands.
Oh!
You know, he like wore... you do a horse, 7.5 hands.
Wait a minute. Measure seven and a half hands. Seven and a half hands?
Seven and a half hands.
Boy, we go around.
That'd make her a 72 C cup.
Seven and a half hands.
No, what she means is glove sizes come in seven
yes,
and a half.
Surely.
But seven and
no,
a half.
Of course. I meant go all the way around the body.
Oh, you mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
Start here and.
Right.
One day, a hugging and a chalking and a begging her to be my bride. When I met another fella with some chalk in his hand, coming around the other side, over the mountain, coming around the other side. Remember that? Hugging and chalking to Hoagy Carmichael? You don't remember it, thank you very much. Okay, Ronnie.
Yes. What? My slide rule.
Slide rule? Seven and a half?
Charles
held up a sign that says, "Don't call us, we'll call you."
I don't.
No, you don't.
No, you don't.
Look, I'm
into all that trouble.
Yeah.
I said, "Shoot, Gene, a good master."
All right, that happens to be the definitive answer there. Okay, size seven and a half. Sales girl said, "How'd you get that measurement?" Jim said, "I measured it with my hat. Certainly, hat seven and a half."
That's what I have.
Men's hat sizes, you know, seven, seven and a quarter, seven and one eighth. That's it. What do you say?
That's the same thing, Fileman.
That's it. Okay, hat. What do you got, Miss Fanny Honey?
Fish well, if you really want to know.
I really want to know.
I said coffee cup.
Coffee cup.
I said coffee cup.
That's a good answer.
Now, what cup do you need? Tell me what a seven and a half coffee cup is.
In Brett's case, demi-tasse cup. What? I don't know. I didn't understand the question, actually.
You didn't? Oh, I
no.
see. Well, that's very kind and honest of you to say so. Well, the score is still tied. You could untie it right after we do a little business with America, so stand by. Watch this. We are ready to carry on. Now, Michael, you're in the catbird seat because all you need to do is match one to win the game. Here it is. Alfredo the bullfighter said, "Hey, in the bull ring, the bulls are always nice to me. And that is because I dress up as a blank."
Alfredo is not a Mexican name. You either get the name with the accent or, you know.
What do you want? What? Give us a name.
Well,
wait, I'll change it right now.
No, you don't have to change it.
I'll change it right now.
I don't think Alfredo is a Mexican name.
All right.
Is it?
How about Ricardo?
Ricardo.
Good. In honor of Montalbán.
Ricardo.
Right. Ricardo.
Good. You'll make the necessary changes in.
Right. In triplicate. Yes. I'll send it to duplicating immediately. Ready, everybody?
Help it.
Susan, are you ready? Susan is not ready.
Yeah.
Okay. Put it in the slide. Here we go. Michael. Ricardo, the bullfighter, said, "In the bull ring, the bulls are always nice to me, and that is because I dress up as a..."
Cow.
Yeah. Cow is good. Certainly.
Very good.
One cow wins the game for him.
One cow wins the game
One
for
cow
him.
Wins
One
the game.
One cow wins the game for him. I say, Senorita Cow.
Cow wins the game. What the rest here? Hold him up, cow. Thank you very much for being with us here on Match Game. Linda Rock, ladies and gentlemen, there she goes. Ready. All right. I see you have biplanes on your tie there. Oh, World War I tie. Now, good luck to Michael Vita. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Waxed blank, $500 for you, Michael. If you match the answer they gave most often. If you match the second most popular answer, $250. And then if you come up with a match with the third most popular answer they wrote down, you get $100. Now, remember, just call on the ones who have a glimmer of intelligence in their eyes. Don't call on the dummies.
Ronnie?
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Artie?
Wait a minute, one at a time.
Yeah, he has to give you an answer.
Ronnie sits there, yeah, good.
Then I can make a fool of myself.
Give us an answer. When he calls on you, give us an answer, Ronnie. That's what you have to do.
Waxed and waned.
Waxed and waned.
See what he meant about the dummies, Michael?
Cancel his renewal.
Sorry.
All right, waxed and waned is one.
Artie?
Waxed floors.
Oh, I got a better one.
Benny.
museum.
Waxed paper.
Now, I ask you to think it over carefully. There may be some other answers that you might like better in addition to those three, waxed and waned, waxed floors, and waxed paper.
I'll go with waxed paper.
Yeah.
Waxed paper. Let's find out if it's up there and so where. Let's take a look at the $100 response. Waxed floor is there.
Okay.
Waxed and waned.
All right, let's take a look at the next one, please.
Waxed feet. Oh, I love waxed feet. Oh, right. I love waxed feet.
Last chance for waxed paper. Here we go. Bam! You got it, Michael. It looks like Michael's been watching the show. He didn't wait for me to do my spiel. He just walked right up to the wheel, and he knows what he has to do. Okay, let's find out if he's going to play for $5,000 or $10,000 here. Spin the wheel, and good luck to you. Let's all root for a double. Ronnie Graham, who gave you waxed and waned. I'm sure you're going to be thrilled to be playing with him. But what the hell, you can't win them all.
That's not fair.
Good luck anyway.
I want to say a few words for waned. I think it's a word that's being not left in the vocabulary. I think it should be. That's why I said it.
Now, good luck. Now, you will give us...
I'm waning now, but watch me wax.
Right. Okay. You will write your answer. He's going to give us a verbal response. You get ready to write.
Okay.
Right now. Okay, right.
The big money, Ronnie.
Write my answer.
Well, first, I have to ask the question, don't I?
Yes, so that's a good right. idea. Well,
that's good.
You're trying to trick me, aren't you? I almost wrote, you know that.
All right, here it is. Classic blank. Classic blank. Classic blank.
To put in the slot, sweetheart.
Put her in the slot?
Yes, your slot.
Oh, they didn't tell you. There it is. Okay, Ronnie's finished. Now, Michael, if you give us the answer that he's got on the card, you get $5,000. What do you say?
Classic cars.
Classic cars. All right. Let's find out what he has on the card. Ronnie, classic cars will get it. Tall skinny guy over there, and we'll bring in Vern Duncan and Jackie Turner. Here we go. Hi. Welcome. Delighted to see both of you. Two games for each of you. Talk to me.
Hi, Gene.
Hi, Jackie.
Hi, Gene.
Oh, hi, Jackie.
How are you, Gene?
Oh, I'm wonderful. Jackie, how are you? Talk to me, honey.
Oh,
what do you want to say? I've been very well, but I'm feeling better every second.
Yeah, I wish I was feeling so good.
Oh, hi, Vern. Oh, yes. All right. We're just going to sit here and talk to each other for a little while. You do anything you want to do. Okay, now where are you from?
I'm from Bullhead City, Arizona.
There's no Bullhead City, Arizona.
That's a tough job.
Bullhead City, Arizona?
Sure.
Never heard of that.
Yes.
Where is that?
It's on the Colorado River.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
What do you do there?
I manage a restaurant, and I just became part owner of this Italian restaurant.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
That's very nice.
Thank you.
Well, good luck to you there and here.
Buona fortuna.
Let's find out about Vern Duncan.
How are you, Gene?
Okay, how are you? All right. We've been through that.
Oh, we have?
Gene's okay.
Okay, thank Well, I'm married. Same woman for better than half a century.
No kidding. Congratulations. That's marvelous.
And I have three children, two sons and a daughter.
Yep.
Nine grandchildren.
Hmm.
I'm retired. I spent about a half a century in aviation.
As
a little bit of everything.
A little bit of everything.
That's right. From A to Z.
In fact, it's a wonderful field.
If you know who Billy Mitchell was,
yep.
I once stood dress parade for him.
You did indeed.
Yes, sir.
He was a great pioneer in American aviation.
He was.
And I guess it was an honor to get to know
him.
Dedicated man to it. Yes. All right. Good luck to both of you. We'll start the game at another date. Next February. Right now, we've got this. You're lovely, both of you.
Oh, thank you, sir.
You be sure to watch your show now, because a little hair on your head could change your whole life.
Oh, it's done all right so far.
Really? Oh, yeah, with 9 grandchildren, I say you're doing okay. Now, Jackie, you can have A or B.
I'll choose B, please.
B for Jackie Turner. The day before Harry's wedding, Harry's girlfriend left him for another guy.
Oh, goodness.
So Harry went to their wedding. But instead of throwing rice, Harry threw blank.
Brett was a pioneer in airlines and all.
Really? Brett was a pioneer in airlines? Tell us about it, Charles.
Both Orville and Wilbur Wright.
Not you. Ready, Jack?
Ready.
The day before Harry's wedding, Harry's girlfriend left him for another guy, so Harry went to their wedding. But instead of throwing rice, Harry threw...
their wedding gifts.
Harry threw their wedding gifts.
Outraged at the audience.
I'm outraged.
At the
terrible. Just, yeah. They turn in 1 second. They're just awful.
They're venting their unresolved hostilities.
Toward their own mother.
Yeah.
Resolve them, then come in.
Show us your answer.
All right. A fit.
Instead of throwing rice, Harry threw a fit. That's good.
Thank you.
That's very good.
It's nice. It's not the definitive answer. It's clever. It's witty. It's very Ronnie Graham. It's very 50s. You must admit that. What I said was A, throw rocks.
Rocks. Right.
I think that is a definitive
answer. That would get to the point.
I chose grenades, Gene.
Grenades. Grenades, eh? Susan, just feeling hostile today?
Spaghetti.
Cooked spaghetti. Oh, that was a mess, wasn't it?
The same way.
Right. Artie?
I've gone to a lot of weddings with Charles.
Hand grenade.
That's right, we met yesterday.
Yes. That's right.
I said hand grenade.
And 3 hand grenades there, Jack. You talk about the audience being hostile. What about that? Throwing a hand grenade. Holy mackerel.
We've done an analysis.
Ready, Vern? Robert said, did you hear that some people in Washington, D.C. are filming a remake of The Invisible Man?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Uh-huh. Mm.
In the starring role, they've got blank.
In Washington?
That's the operative phrase. In Washington, D.C., doing a remake of The Invisible Man, and in the starring role, they've got blank. Think about it. Think about it, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Mm.
The starring role they've got.
You finished in a big hurry.
Well, this has both political and show business overtones, doesn't it?
Oh, that's a good one.
He has a lot of things going for him.
Yes, excellent. Good. Invisible Man.
Invisible Man.
Washington, D.C. Invisible Man.
Right.
Washington, D.C.
Okay.
Who would star in that role?
Uh-huh.
Should we write her a letter?
She's not feeling
good. Vern, Robert said, did you hear that some people in Washington, D.C. are filming a remake of The Invisible Man? And in the starring role, they've got...
Vice President.
The Vice President.
Vice President.
The Vice President.
Perfect answer.
That's a good answer. Very good answer.
A traditional of political jokes in this country, the Vice President, everybody forgets who he is half the time, and he, in fact, becomes the Invisible Man, so that is really an excellent answer.
It's the best answer.
What have you got?
I haven't got it.
You haven't got it?
Gerald Ford.
Gerald Ford. He's been fairly visible lately. What do you say?
Well, I figure anytime there's a political question, if you just write Nixon, you can't go wrong.
Right.
Well, I didn't know what to write, so I wrote this because I thought Henry might have been a friend of his, Teddy Roosevelt.
Teddy. Teddy.
Roosevelt.
Teddy Roosevelt.
Speed up, speed up,
speed up.
No, I'm not going to speed up. This is as fast as I can go. Hello, Susan.
I thought that someone you could see right through, and I thought that would be Nixon.
And everybody could see through him at the end, but not in the beginning. What do you got?
This man disappeared several years ago.
Spiro, the Invisible Man.
Would he had always been invisible.
I thought that was quite
good. That's not a match.
He was vice president.
No.
I take my job seriously.
Yes.
I thought a while. Who's the vice president?
Walter Mondale.
Right.
Okay. All right.
Oh,
stand by for round two. Right now, this is for you.
Yeah.
Hardy Johnson. Oh, it's time to say goodbye. Goodbye. Thank you, Gene Baker. So long. Hey.
Sunburn, insect bites, scrapes, and scratches, use MediQuick, the quick medicine that soothes pain and helps prevent infection. And B-Fresh makes every flush a deodorizing shower to automatically freshen and help fight bowl ring buildup in three original scents, plus new powder fresh. Put a shower in your bowl. And a paper-made family of products including freezer wrap to protect the foods you freeze, baking cups, coffee filters, and paper-made plastic cups for all occasions. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.